and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss average. Let us start with the definition. An average is a single value which represents the whole set of figures and all other items concentrate around it . It is also called as measure of central tendency . The general formula for the average of n quantities x1, x2, x3 up to xn is given by pth root of one upon n into x1 raised to power p plus x2 raised to power p plus x3 raised to power p plus and so on up to xn raised to power p, where n belongs to n, the set of natural numbers, and p is an integer. It also satisfies the test of the correctness of the formula, as if all individual members are equal. The pth root of 1 by n into k raised to power p plus k raised to power p plus k raised to power p plus and so on k raised to power p n times which is equal to pth root of 1 upon n into n into k raised to power p, which is equal to pth root of k raised to power p, that is equal to k, as p can take any value from infinite integral values. Therefore, range of choice for the definition of an average is also infinite. Now, if we take p is equal to 1, then the formula for the average is one upon n into x1 raised to power 1 plus x2 raised to power 1 plus and so on up to xn raised to power 1 whole raised to power 1 upon 1, which is equal to x1 plus x2 plus and so on up to xn whole upon n. This is the formula for simple arithmetic average or mean of n quantities. That is, mean n is equal to x1 plus x2 plus and so on up to xn whole upon n. Or we can also write it as n is equal to summation of x by n for simple distribution. And n is equal to f1 into x1 plus f2 into x2 plus and so on up to fn into xn whole upon f1 plus f2 plus and so on up to fn, which can also be written as n is equal to summation of f into x upon summation of f for a frequency distribution. Now, if the value of p is equal to 2, then the formula reduces to that is, we put the value of p as 2 in this formula and we get square root of 1 by n into x1 square plus x2 square plus and so on up to xn square. This formula is used to calculate standard deviation. Standard deviation denoted by sigma is equal to square root of x1 minus m the whole square plus x2 minus m the whole square and so on up to xn minus m the whole square whole upon m. Here the standard deviation is defined as the average of deviations x1 minus m, x2 minus m, x3 minus m and so on up to xn minus m. Now p is equal to 2 is chosen as square of the deviation is always positive irrespective of the positive or negative deviation. If the value of x is given in centimeters, then the value of x minus m the whole square will be in square centimeters. And standard deviation sigma, which is the square root of summation of x minus m the whole square by n, will again be in centimeters. Now we are going to discuss weighted arithmetic average. Let us suppose a student scores 65 marks out of 75 in science. He scores 42 out of 50 in computers and 90 out of 100 in mathematics. To find the average, we cannot reckon science, mathematics and computers as equal. Therefore, we have to give weight to each of the subject. If we give one weight to mathematics, and the maximum marks is 100, then we give 75 upon 100, that is 3 by 4, 2 signs. Since 75 is the maximum marks in science, and we give 50 by 100, that is 1 by 2, 2 computers. Since 50 is the maximum marks in computers, therefore we can say the appropriate proportional weights are 1:3/4:1/2, or we can also write it as 4:3:2. Hence we can define it as, if there are n quantities, that is x1, x2, x3 and so on up to xn, and W1, W2, W3 and so on up to Wn are their respective weights, then the weighted arithmetic average is given by x1 into W1 plus x2 into W2 plus x3 into W3 plus and so on up to xn into Wn whole upon W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus and so on up to Wn, which can be written as summation of x into W upon summation of W. Let us take an example. Suppose there are 5 men, 3 women and 2 boys, and their daily wages are $100 for a man, $75 for a woman and $50 for a boy. Then the weighted arithmetic average of their daily wages is, here we can say that the value of x1 is given as 100, the value of x2 is given as 75 and the value of x3 is given as 50, and their corresponding values for weight, that is W1 is given as 5, W2 is equal to 3 and W3 is equal to 2, then weighted arithmetic average of their daily wages is given by W1 into x1 plus W2 into X2 plus W3 into X3 whole upon W1 plus W2 plus W3, which is equal to W1 into X1, that is 5 into 100, plus W2 into X2, that is 3 into 75, plus W3 into X3, that is 2 into 50 upon W1 plus W2 plus W3, that is 5 plus 3 plus 2, that is 5 into 100, that is 500, plus 3 into 75, that is 225, plus 2 into 50, that is 100, whole upon 5 plus 3 plus 2, that is 10. Therefore we have 500 plus 225 plus 100, that is 825 by 10, which is equal to 82.5. Therefore, the weighted arithmetic average of the daily wages is given by $82.5, which is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.